I'm so proud of the way that our firm has become involved with and is handling cases for children who were lead poisoned by drinking water in Flint, Michigan. Everybody's already heard the story and the narrative that's been sort of put out by the media. The narrative is typically about the government and the people in the government that made decisions that ultimately poisoned the population. The other part of the narrative that's always discussed is the composition of the community and how it's a primarily minority community. But throughout the course of the narrative being told over and over again to our country by way of the media, what's really been lost is the effect that the lead poisoning will have on not only the entire population, but more specifically on the children in Flint, not just today, but for generations to come. We are to date the only lawyers who are filing individual cases for individual children who were lead poisoned. And it's an expensive process, it's a grueling, time-consuming process, but we now represent over 1,200 children. And if each child has his own unique potential, and if lead poisoning steals potential from a child by way of cognitive deficits and brain damage, then every child deserves to have his own case because every child is damaged in a different way. And I'm just honored that our firm has chosen the harder path, the more difficult path, the path that very few, if anybody else, has even explored, let alone gotten on. And we are truly trying to honor the children of Flint in a way that nobody else is. Everything's been taken from them with regard to their potential. And all we can do is try and give them that potential back by way of a judgment or a verdict. And the only way we know how to do that, and the only way to properly honor them, is to allow each of them to have individual cases. And that's what we have done and will continue to do for the children we represent in Flint.